Hello, welcome back. In this tutorial we are going to see how to make a PCB for the design we have made. So open project. You have to open the same project file of the GuyCAD, and in the schematic you will directly enter in the schematic mode. In the schematic you have to assign the footprints to the each component. What is the footprint? I will explain you that. The footprint is nothing but the how many holes or how what will be the placement on the PCB for the particular component. Consider it is a resistor. Resistor will have the two pins which will go through the PCB, and from the back side you will solder from the copper end. Now that is the footprint. If there is a resistor, there are two holes on the PCB, that is a footprint for the resistor. For the LED, there are two pins, anode and cathode, which will be go through the PCB, and from the back side you will solder the pins. So that is the footprint for the LED. And for the battery, you can consider if it is a CMOS battery, it will have the two pins again, and one placeholder from the upper side of the PCB, and where you will attach the CMOS cell. So right now we are going to assign some footprints. For the battery I am going to add two pins. For the resistor it will be a resistor footprint, and for the LED it will be a LED footprint. Now in this menu, that is assigning the footprint or associate the component and the footprints, you have to click on it. It will download some contents from the internet, from the GitHub website. In some other tutorials I will explain you how to download locally, so you don't have to go to the internet to download it from the GitHub every time you assign the footprints. For this time you will wait for some moments. Now this window is up. In this window you will have the three sections. First section is the library that GuyCAD currently has. Second section, this part is the components that you have in your design, and this part you will see what is this part now in the applications. Now there are three components, first battery, LED and the resistor. You don't have to give the names, it will import from that design. So first of all we will assign the footprint to the battery. So select the battery. I am going to add the two pins for the connections. So there is one library that is a pin header. It is nothing but the burp strip. So on this section you will see which are the libraries it has, and it will adapt according to the components you have. As the battery has the two points, it will only show the two pointed footprints. So for the battery I am going to use the two pins, that is 1 by 2 2.54 mm, that is a pitch of that pinhole. So you have to double click it, it will get assigned. Next is LED. I have to find the LED library for that. So there is LED, and these are the footprints that under that library. Now consider that you don't know what is the name of that particular footprint. So for that you can see this is the LED which I have selected. This is the battery you select or the resistor you select, it will show on the design. So I am going to assign the footprint to the LED. So consider that I am considering this footprint. So but you don't know how does it look, so you have to click on it. That is a view selected footprint. It will show you how does it look in the PCB design. Okay, so you can select whichever footprint you want, whether it is SMD, there are some SMD options. Okay, so right now I am just using the 3 mm LED. You have to double click on it. Then again for the resistor you have to find the resistor, that's a through hole. Now I am going to select the resistor footprint. Consider this is the footprint I am going to use. So double click on it, it will get assigned. Now all the footprints has been assigned. Now next thing is to make a PCB. Make the PCB. So you save it and close it. Then again save the project. So otherwise if you will lose all your development. So next is this GuyCAD work on a netlist format of the designs. So we have to export the netlist, generate. so it will generate in the same folder, so you have to save it. And next part, that is making a PCB, this is the last thing, that is a PCB. You have to click on it, it will open up in the PCB view, that is a perspective for the PCB making. And next thing that you have to import the netlist you just exported from the schematic perspective, you have to read netlist. Then currently whatever the locations you have set for the netlist, you have to read the netlist from that. It will show if there is enough. Right now all the green are there, that means all the footprints and the components have been imported to the design successfully, and then close. You can see there are the components which I have imported from the netlist. Now I will show you how to place these components and how to make the PCB. Click on the component which you want to place, then move, that is the M key, so you can move it. Using the R you can rotate it. So right now, consider I am placing it here. So next, using the mouse wheel, you can zoom in and zoom out. So I am again selecting the LED and then placing it here. Next is a battery connector. These are the two pins, and again you copy it, you can rotate it, sorry, you can move it using M, you can rotate it using R. So consider this is a simple PCB I am going to make. Now next thing is connecting these pins. Okay, so there is add track or the wires, you just have to click on it, and next you have to press. That means if it is upper copper or bottom copper of the PCB. If you want the copper side on from the back side, you have to put the copper and the on the back side of the PCB. So that is selected using the this layer visibles. So you have to click whether it is a front copper or it is a back copper. So right now I have selected it is a back copper, and simply you have to click and go to the pins where it was showing. The yellow line will show where it is connected in the schematic, but the thickness of this track is not so good, so you can give the width for that track using design rules. Then design rules, go to the design rules, there is a track width. I am going to give the 1 mm of the track width. So I will, now you can see this is sorry, so this is the track width I have increased. Now connect it. The yellow line will show or it will guide you to which point you have to go. Okay, so we have connected every track, but next part is, this is only the connections. There is no any PCB edge you have given. So right now we are going to do the edge. So there is edge cut, and then graphic line you have to select. You have to give the edge to the PCB. Okay, so now we have given the edge to the PCB. Next thing, there is a problem. This is the PCB which you have made, but you don't know how it will be designed after the manufacturing. So you want the first look of that PCB. So there is a view and then 3D viewer. You can check how it will look after the manufacturing. So you can then decide whether the placement of the component on the PCB is okay or not. You can change it accordingly in this. So this was the PCB design. So next part is exporting the PDF or any Gerber files, so you can manufacture this PCB. So for that file, you have to give the PDF or the Gerber file for the production of that PCB. Here I am putting the PDF right now. So we will plot, we will select the PDF, that is a back copper only, and then drill size will be the actual size. Then browse to the design. I will make a folder, that is PCB. In that folder I am going to plot the PDF file. So right now we have a PCB which is completed, and then the PDF file which will be used for the manufacturing. So let us check whether we have all the design things with us. Now this is the project explorer. You have the PCB folder. In that PCB folder you have the PDF files. We have the schematic, we have the PCB, netlist, libraries you have used, and the PCB that you have made. So right now I will show you. This is the folder, then PCB design, then PCB. You have this PDF which you can print and you can make the PCB out of it. Okay, this is the PCB that you can use. This PCB can be transported to the manufacturing, and you can make your first prototype of this circuit if you want. Okay, so that was the second tutorial in the KiCad. I hope you have understood the basics of the making the PCB from the schematic and using the footprints. So this was it. In the next video I will show you how to use the libraries of the KiCad locally. So see you in the next video. For now, bye.